dear students, so here we are going to start an interesting topic, which is, this is a course which is introduction to probability. So this is a course which is introduction to probability. So this is basically a course for beginners. If you are, you know, you just are going to start your probability course, this is the first time you are studying probability, or maybe you have studied little bit of probability in, you know, in your school days, so then this course is for you. And we will try to, you know, bring it to an advanced level too, but we will cover every basic in this course, right? So if you already familiar with most of the probability theorems and laws, then this may not be the course for you. But if you want to learn from the beginning, then this course is for sure it's for you. Okay, so let us see what is probability. So you see, everything around us, most of the things happening around us, they are uncertain, right, to some extent. For example, if you look for the weather, tomorrow's weather, so this is an uncertain thing. Tomorrow it may be rainy, it may be sunny, it may be windy. So there are so many possibilities for the weather tomorrow. Or suppose you are playing a game, simple game, you are playing a game, right? Say suppose you are playing Ludo, right? So you are rolling a dice. So you can, when you roll a dice, you can get either 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6. So that again is an uncertain event, right? So you see, everything around us is most of the times uncertain, right? And that uncertainty is nothing but, you know, when you try to study that uncertainty, that is probability. So if we there is a famous quote by Laplace, the famous mathematician. He said that probability is common sense reduced to calculation. So he said that probability is common sense reduced to calculations. So common sense means, because I told you that everything around us is, you know, having some amount of uncertainty, so that is why he's calling it as common sense. Like, it is actually required in your daily life. Even if you are not doing mathematics, if you are not a mathematics student, then also you need probability to, you know, deal with your daily life things, right? So that is why he said that probability is a common sense reduced to calculations. So this is by famous mathematician Laplace. You must have heard about Laplace transformations, and there are so many things done by Laplace, right? So now I think you are convinced that most of the things around us, they are uncertain, right? For example, if you play a game, you will win or lose. That is uncertain, right, in the beginning of the game. So you would like to know that what is the probability of you winning the game and what is the probability of you losing the game, right? So things like that. So if I toss a coin, unbiased coin, so we have head and tail, two possibilities are there. So I would like to know how likely is the event of getting a head, and how likely is the event of getting a tail. So all these things, that the likelihood of happening of one particular thing, like we want, suppose this is the outcome you are interested in, so you would like to know that what is the chances of getting head. So that thing, the calculation of chances, is nothing but computing the probabilities, right? So the most important thing, so from here we conclude that we have an experiment, right? So we have an uncertain event, right? So you have something, you can call it as uncertain situation. So you have an uncertain situation, right? Uncertain situation means the outcomes are more than one. Outcomes are more than one. Fine. So this is an uncertain situation. Can you think of a situation which is certain, right? So you can just think of a situation which is certain, right? So you can just type in the comment box that what situations are there which are certain, where the outcome is for sure one, right? So here, uncertain situations means outcome is more than one. So we have, for example, rolling a die, okay, or you have tossing a coin, right? So playing a game, winning and losing are the two outcomes, right? And so on. So in if you roll a die, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 as your possible outcomes, and 6. When you toss a coin, you have head and tail. When you play a game, you have win or lose, right? So these are the possible outcomes. So you have an uncertain situation, right? And you are interested in like what is the chances of getting 1, what are the chances of getting 2, what are the chances of getting 3. And similarly, here you are interested in what is the chances of getting head, what are the chances of getting tail, right? So what we do, we use some mathematics, right? And we model this uncertain situation into a mathematical thing, and that mathematical thing is called a probabilistic model. So we do the mathematical description of this uncertain situation, and that gives you a probabilistic model. Okay, so probabilistic model is nothing but just you are writing whatever is happening in your uncertain situation in terms of mathematics, right? So a probabilistic model of an uncertain situation consists of two parts. One is called sample space and the other is called probability law. Okay, so today in this video we will be just discussing about sample space. We will be discussing about what is a sample space. So that is, you see, the topic of the video is sample spaces. So sample space we are going to discuss, right? So let us see what are sample spaces. So you have, again I will say, you have an uncertain event. Okay, let me write down as a situation, right? So let me take this as, there are so many examples, I am taking this as rolling a die. Okay, so possible outcomes, set of all possible outcomes is called a sample space, For example, in this particular case, when you roll a die, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is a set of all possible outcomes. So we will call it as a sample space. Okay, so this is a sample space. This is a sample space for the, sometimes people call it as experiment. Uncertain situation, they call it as an experiment. Okay, for the experiment of rolling a die. Okay, now you have, suppose, let us take another experiment. So I have another experiment of tossing a coin, right? So what are your possible outcomes? So possible outcomes are either head or tail. There are only two outcomes. So this is your sample space in this experiment. So this is your uncertain situation, which we are calling as an experiment, that you are tossing a coin. So either you will get a head or you will get a tail. So this is your sample space, right? Now you may have so many experiments. So let us just check so that it is clear to you. So suppose you are having in this experiment of throwing two dice. Right, so what are the possible outcomes? So you can have 1 on the first dice and 1 on the second. Then you can have 1 on the first dice, 2 on the second. 1 on the first dice, 3 on the second. 1 on the first dice, 4 on the second. 1 on the first dice, 5 on the second. Then you can have 1 on the first dice, 6 on the second. Or you can have 2 on the first die, 1 on the second. 2 on the first dice, 2 on the second. 2 on the first dice, 3 on the second. 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6. Or you can have 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. Then you can have 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3, 4, 4, 4, 5, 4, 6, and so on. Then you can have 5, 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4, 5 5 and 5 6. Then you can have 6 1, 6 2, 6 3, 6 4, 6 5 and 6 6. Okay, so this is a set of all the possible outcomes. Now you can count, they are actually 36, right? Why 36? Because we already know from our combinations and permutation that there are 6 ways to fill this box, that is the first outcome, and 6 ways to fill this box. So total number of outcomes are 36, right? So basically a sample space is nothing but total number of outcomes. You just not the total number of outcomes, you just put every outcome in a set. So sample space is a set containing all the possible outcomes of an experiment or of an uncertain situation. Okay, now there are some things which you should be careful about sample space. So one of the thing is that each of the element should be mutually exclusive, right? We cannot have, for example, if you are rolling a die and in the sample space you cannot have something like this 1 or 3, 1 or 4. So you cannot list them as your outcomes. They are not the outcomes. They cannot be the elements of the sample space. Why? Because if you roll a die and you get 1, then you don't know whether this is your outcome or this is your outcome. So this is the one thing, that your elements should be mutually exclusive. The elements of the sample space should be mutually exclusive. That is the thing you should take care of. And then you should take, so let me write down. So we have these things as, what we can say that this is note for sample space. Right. So one is that elements of sample space should be mutually exclusive. And then you have the second one, which says that the sample space should be exhaustive. Sample space should be exhaustive. So what is the meaning of this sentence? It means that, for example, I cannot leave any of the outcome. For example, if I'm saying that rolling a die, and if I am saying 1 2 5 4, I have left 6 and 3. Okay, 6 and 3 are not there. So this is not a sample space. Why? Because it is not exhaustive. Means you have to list all the possible outcomes. So that is the meaning of exhaustive sample spaces. So our sample spaces has to be exhaustive, right? And there is one more thing, that sample space may change according to the question which is being asked. For example, I'll give you an example. You consider these two alternative games. Consider the following two alternative games, both involving 10 successive coin tosses. Two alternative games, both involving tossing a coin successively 10 times, right? So we have the first game is we receive $1 each time a head comes up. And game two is that we receive first $1 for every coin toss up to and including the first time we get a head comes up. Okay, then after that, when the first time there is an head, then we receive $2 for every coin toss up to the second time a head comes up. Okay, more generally the dollar amount per toss is doubled. The dollar amount per toss is doubled each time a head comes up. Each time a head comes up. Okay, now you see, these are the two situations. Here I am saying that we receive $1 each time a head comes up, and you are throwing a coin 10 times. You are tossing a coin 10 times. So this is a simple situation. Now you see here, if I am interested in what is the sample space here. So you see here, we are not interested that what is the sequence of heads and tails. We are just interested in how many heads we got, because for every head we are getting $1. That's it. We are not interested in whether the first toss is a head or second toss is head. So here we are interested in how many heads are there. So what will be our sample space? Either you get a 0 head or 1 head or 2 head or 3 head or 4 head or 5 head or 6 head or 7 head or 8 head or 9 head or 10. So this is a sample space. Sample space of 11 elements. So here our sample space is sample space containing 11 elements. So cardinality is 11. Is that okay? So here if I started in the sample space, I can also go like this. Head, 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 head. 10 times I got head. Or I got head, tail, head, tail, head, tail, head, tail, head, tail, head, tail. Or I got tail, head, tail, head, tail, head, tail, head, tail, head, and so on. So this is very big. So this is not required. This is unnecessary, because here in this outcome and in this outcome, I am getting same 5 number of heads. So this is unnecessarily. So this is not required. So in the sample space, you have to make sure that one thing is, it has to be exhaustive. It means that all the information you are covering, but it should not be extra information. For example, if for this particular game, you are going to take this as your sample space, this will be quite big, right? So it will contain 2^10 elements, right? Because you have 10 boxes, right? You can think of like this. So you have 10 boxes, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and each you can fill with head or tail, right? So 2 possibilities here, 2 here, 2 here, 2 here. So total are 2^10 elements. So in this game, so I just want to tell you that not only your sample space has to be exhaustive, it should be there that extra information should be avoided. So this is not required sample space. This particular one here is not the required sample space for your game 1. This is not the required sample space for game 1. Now you look at game 2. Now in the game 2, we receive $1 for every coin toss up to and including the first time a head comes up. And after that, you started getting $2. And after that, you will be getting $4 and so on. So here, the sequence of heads and tails is important. Here, the sequence of heads and tails is important, because that decides what happens, right? So here we will use this particular sample space. Here we would like to, write down your sequence. For example, you have head, 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 right? So here you see, you will receive $1. Then, because next time you get head, $2, $4, $8, $16, $32, $64, $128, $256, and $512. So this is the most favorable thing which can happen. And if you are getting something like tail, 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 so here you will get nothing. So this is the one which we don't want, right? So here the sequence of events is important. So this is going to be your sample space, right? So here the sample space will get 2^10 elements. Is that okay? So I think sample space is clear. So sample space is the set of all possible outcomes, but obviously you should avoid unnecessarily information, and also you should be very much clear that your sample space is exhaustive, right? And then before ending this video, I would like to tell you what is an event. So suppose you have a sample space S. For example, we have rolling a die. So we have here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. They are the possible outcomes. Then any subset of this will be your event. For example, here you can have 5 as your empty set, 1 as your empty set, 5 as your subset, 1 as your subset, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or you can have 1, 2, 1, 3, and so on, right? So there will be so many subsets. So all the subsets of the sample space, they are called events. So what is an event? A subset of a sample space, a subset of a sample space is called an event, right? So here we, in this video, we have defined what is a sample space and what is an event, right? So this is one of the ingredient for probabilistic model. And what is your probabilistic model? Probabilistic model is mathematical description of an uncertain situation. So in the next video, we'll be discussing the second ingredient of probabilistic model, that is your probability law. Thank you for watching this video. Please share this video and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.